We're but 3 weeks away from the Royal Rumble. And look who's headed to the square circle. Yet another participant in the Royal Rumble.
I'll tell you one thing, I can't wait to get my hands around that perfect little neck of his and squeeze it till his eyeballs pop out.
The Berserker, yet another participant in the Royal Rumble. Everyone wanting to win the Royal Rumble. And that is the personification of perfection. Mr. Perfect, you probably saw him last week. Wade Boggs, six-time American League batting champion, and now current New York Yankee, was really impressed with the perfect swing of Mr. Perfect.
And one of the balls he hit just came down just about 30 seconds ago.
Oh, yeah. Well, he's real good at hitting balls and throwing balls. I understand he's pretty good at throwing knives, too. He threw a big knife right in the back of his best friend, Bobby Heenan.
It was a good shot.
He's a backstabber.
Well, I'm sure Ric Flair and Razor Ramon would agree with those comments, indeed. But nonetheless, Mr. Perfect is his own man. This will be most interesting to see what happens when you take a brawler like Berserker and put him in the ring with a man who has highly tuned technical skills like Mr. Perfect.
Mr. Perfect is no stranger to brawling either.
That's true.
You know, this could be a good little preview of what to expect at Royal Rumble. We see who comes out on top here in this match.
And exchange right away here, and where she stops, nobody knows. Off the rope, Mr. Perfect ducking the big foot and ducking the clothesline in. Right on target with a drop. Whoa, look at that.
Mr. Perfect alone in the ring.
I guess you'd think that was a perfect drop kick, too, huh?
No question about it. Berserker rolling back in. No telling what this man's going to do. Oh, look at that. Very unorthodox. A lunge with his head. Berserker hammering away. Berserker forearm smash. Berserker with Mr. Perfect in a bit of trouble now. And look at that right to the buckle.
Mm-hmm. Big handful of that perfect hair there.
The Berserker's got raw power, there's no doubt about that.
For sure, reversal by Perfect. Perfect moving in but missing, grabbing his shoulder right into the ring post.
A friend is hurt right there. That's an iron ring post.
Uh-oh, wait a minute.
Come on!
Whoa! Look at that! I can't believe that idiot would try something like that.
Talk about throwing knives, King.
We could have seen a great little decapitation. That would have been wonderful.
Jack Tunney, president of the WWF, I'm sure, is going to have something to say about that, if not Sergeant Slaughter. There's no room for those kinds of actions in the WWF. And I would think psychologically, that really has Mr. Perfect shook. Off the rope. Oh, look at this. Over the top of the out.
Long way down for a big man.
Whoa. What's this? Ric Flair is coming to ringside. He has no business there.
He may be the real Mr. Perfect. Look at him.
Ric Flair calling out Mr. Perfect. Wait a minute. Coming up from behind now. Keep your eye on Berserker.
Turn around, Perfect.
Berserker hammering away.
The Perfect's a fighter, there's no doubt about that. But he's still got his attention on Ric Flair.
Yeah, but it's like the Rumble is being hit by all sides. Look at this. Get that man out of here. He has no business being here.
Perfect better pay attention to what's going on in the ring and forget about Ric Flair.
You're right about it, because I don't think Ric Flair wants to beat him. That hurt him.
Berserker nailing Mr. Perfect. Rick, we'll be right back with more WWF action. Get him out of there. We're back with more WWF action. The official has just returned after escorting Ric Flair back to the locker room. The action continues here.
for that last exchange.
This is going to be a real gut check for Mr. Perfect. Intestinal fortitude. I'm talking courage, King, for Mr. Perfect.
I'm talking, if you get right down to it, he should have already been counted out. The referee was gone, taking Ric Flair back.
And that may do it. Two and three. Mr. Perfect barely getting that right shoulder up off the mat. Berserker persistent as ever. A whip to the ropes, off in the back. No,
wait a minute. There's the perfect.
Unbelievable. On his toes in a three count, dig it.
Executed perfectly, I might add, King.
Oh, well, yeah.
Like I said, big ego. I understand that this guy has a custom-made telephone. It doesn't ring, it applauds.
Ooh. Well, it could be applauding at the Royal Rumble.
Yeah, you got it. Perfect. To the update we go.
You know something, Mr. Perfect. You got a pretty high opinion of yourself. You think you are the perfect athlete? The perfect wrestler? Well, after Ric Flair gets finished with you, you are going to be flawed, scarred, and tarnished. Which is why I will unveil to you, Mr. Perfect, and to all the humanoids throughout the world at the Royal Rumble, someone who is beyond perfect. Someone who not only has a high opinion of himself, but is justifiably, truly in love with himself. And then, Mr. Perfect, when you feast your eyes on the person that I will unveil at the Royal Rumble, you will look back and say, "Why, I wasn't perfect at all. I didn't really measure up. I was really nothing without the influence of Bobby the Brain. If only I could look like Narcissus." That's right. All you ham and eggers at the Royal Rumble, the drape will drop. And so will the mouths of every man, woman, and child when you feast your eyes on Narcissus.
From the locker room area, I'm here with the Rocket, Owen Hart. Owen, things are really going your way these days, aren't they?
That's right. You know, Raymond, 1992 has been a great year for high energy and Coca Beware and myself, and I think 1993 is going to be a lot of fun, and I hope for a lot more success in the future.
Very good. It's a known fact that the WWE champion, Bret the Hitman Hart, is your brother. But you must be concerned that at the pace that he is going, he will burn himself out.
Well, that is true, Raymond. Bret is working at a very hard pace, but he is WWE champion, and I think that's expected of him. Just like myself, we always try to give 100% and be the best we can be.
Owen, I have to ask you this. I heard that when you were a youngster that your father used to take you downstairs to the basement, which you referred to as the dungeon, and that's where you learned how to wrestle. Is that true?
That is true. There's eight boys in my family, and my father always wanted a wrestling background in all of his sons. So he'd get us down in the basement, and sometimes I'd wrestle Bret, sometimes it was another brother, as long as I didn't have to get my dad, because he was the best wrestler around, and I sure didn't want to get in there with him.
Obviously, your father was a big influence on you and on Bret.
Hey, Rocket, your daddy teach you that one, man? Hey, Rocket, you tell your big brother, man, the WWE champion, you tell him Razor said he's next.
You know, Razor Ramon, we were already signed for our title match in the Royal Rumble, but you had to get my attention, didn't you?
You had to jump my brother like a dirty scum. Well, you know, Razor Ramon, you've got my attention now. This match isn't just going to be a title match. It's become real personal. And I can promise you one thing in the Royal Rumble. The Hart family will get its revenge.
It's the Royal Rumble! It's the Royal Rumble!
Everybody knows that the Royal Rumble is IRS's favorite because there's 28 tax cheats in the ring at the same time. That's excluding Mr. DiBiase and myself, of course.
And the prize at the end of this Royal Rumble is a shot at the World Wrestling Federation Heavyweight Champion, no matter who it happens to be at the time. And should it end up Irwin and myself, the last two in the ring? Well, the best man win. Irwin thinks he's the best. I think I'm the best. But the bottom line is, the money and the title all go to Money Incorporated.
If you're talking about the Royal Rumble, you gotta be talking about the Nature Boy Ric Flair. Last year, Auburn in New York, at the Royal Rumble, I beat 29 of the greatest WWF superstars all in one night. It lasted an hour and 10 minutes. It was the Nature Boy that won it all. So this year, the Royal Rumble, all the big stars of the WWF and Mr. Perfect, I'll be coming for you. Woo!
Beverly Brothers, you have the pleasure of wrestling my brother and I at Royal Rumble. When the match is finished, the pleasure's all ours.
This is our first Royal Rumble, and Beverly Brothers, we're not taking you lightly. But one thing for sure, after the match is over, we're going to be the only ones celebrating.
We're back with more WWF action. It seems like everyone who's anyone is getting involved now in the 30-man over the top rope Royal Rumble.
Here is Dave.
He didn't seem too impressed by my artwork while ago.
Hey, listen, a lot of times you say something you really don't know what you're talking about.
Well, I know what I'm talking about when I look at him. In January, if he had any brains at all, he would be sitting on the beach in Hawaii instead of being in a ring with me and 29 other individuals in the Royal Rumble.
Oh, I don't know about that. I mean, it is so prestigious, the winner of the Royal Rumble, to face the WWF champion, whomever that may be, at WrestleMania.
I'm looking forward to it.
Every man for himself. You'll be hit from the right, the left, from the top to the bottom, from all sides in the Rumble.
And even under the ring, that's where Lawler's going to be drawing pictures.
Oh, listen to this.
That remains to be seen. Macho Man.
Possible.
Tight waist and nice takedown.
Big strong guy. Wrestling knowledge there. Scientific. Yeah, I'm impressed.
Crush all over his opposition, Dave Siegfrieds. Hanging on the rope. I guess that's one way to break it up. Uh-oh, he's back. What's he doing back?
He probably wants to buy that painting I did of him a while ago.
You really think that's who Damien
is? Look at that. That is not
cool. Now, that is funny.
No, that's not cool. That is not cool right there. I'll guarantee you that.
Siegfrieds off the rope. Nice. No, look, can't get the big man down. We had an occasional chat with Crush earlier on about his participation in the Royal Rumble. Here's what he said.
Aloha, everybody. This is Crush wishing you all a very haole makahikiho, which means Happy New Year. Royal Rumble, right around the corner, brah. This is Crush's chance, once and for all, to prove exactly where I want to be in the World Wrestling Federation, and that's on top. Royal Rumble, I'm coming for one reason and one reason only, and that is to win, brother. Shaka from Crush.
Shaka!
Well, he's going to go home a sad man after the Royal Rumble.
Rush taking a couple of elbows there into the kisser. Going downstairs now is opposition Siegfrieds. Nice reversal. Big man gets Siegfried coming off the rope. Passing rope. Drives it into the back.
That's raw power right there. Shaka, big man. And that's not cool again. I'll tell you what.
That lady looks like she needs a shower anyway.
Ooh, wow.
That was not funny at all.
Throw him on top of the clown, Crush.
Look at this. Crush with the big man up above and down to the canvas.
Uh-huh. And come into the ring and get some of that.
Yeah. Oh, wow. Dropping the big leg.
Shaka.
impress you, Macho Man, but it didn't impress the clown. He's just laughing at him.
All right now, Dave, Siegfried is not laughing at all. The big man from Kona applying his hold. More and more pressure on Siegfried.
We're going to get some pineapple juice here in a second.
Ooh, down to the canvas. And Siegfried is likely to submit. Referee right there, and it's all over.
Shakabra.
On those kids. They love that clown.
I think they're smiling at this man. Oh, look at this.
Here's the replay. There is Crush, and he has got to be the biggest, strongest guy in the WWF. Here's the big Shakabra, the Crush.
To the outside, once again, victorious on his way to the Royal Rumble. Crush. We'll be back as we continue with more W.
Wrong guy.
Let's stay with the action.
That's funny.
Wrong guy.
He's just throwing that ball right into some little kid's face.
He just hit somebody right in the face.
Hey, don't put your hands on the clowns. Look, all he's trying to do is say, I'm just trying to have some fun here.
Yeah, he's giving him a warning. Those are his people out there.
Well, he just hit some kids in the face with that ball. I think that's perhaps what Crush is taking exception to.
Exactly.
It's just a little rubber ball. That's not going to hurt anybody.
Crush certainly has that clown by the arm.
Trying to break his arm.
Here's a warning from Crush, clown.
Yeah. A big warning.
Really? From a big man. See that? That clown's not. He's not cool at all.
That's a true clown. He can find humor in anything.
Well, he's certainly enjoying himself right now, but he wasn't enjoying himself a few moments ago when Crush had him by the arm. I wonder what Crush had to say. Perhaps we can get some comments from Crush a little bit later on. This is not a laughing matter as we take you now to the event center.
Crush, obviously you were not amused by the clown's antics. What did you tell him?
Well, first of all, Raymond, I happen to know a little bit about clowns, okay? My grandfather was a clown, and he worked very, very hard to make kids and everybody laugh. And he was a pleasure to be around. This guy, he does nothing but hurt people, and the only person laughing is him, okay? Now, the wrestlers, picking on the wrestlers, playing jokes on the wrestlers was bad enough. When he started picking on the kids, bruh, he stepped way out of bounds. Now, I've given you a very, very stiff warning, and I hope for your sake, you'll take my advice. That's it, bruh.
Ladies and gentlemen, my guest this week is accompanied by his manager, Dr. Harvey Whippleman, and his handler, Kimchi, the Ugandan giant, the mighty Kamala.
Take a look at this trio. What a trifecta, huh?
Boy, you bet. Dr. Harvey, I wouldn't let him treat me for a handman.
Dr. Whippleman, it's obvious to me and to everyone that since Kamala was put into that coffin at Survivor Series, that he is not the same man.
You're exactly right. This is not the same Kamala, because the Kamala that got put in the coffin at Survivor Series was trying to think for himself, when we all know that he's a stupid, ignorant, backwards, savage. So now, through our positive reinforcement, he will listen to what we say. He will do what we tell him, because he has no mind of his own. He has no brain of his own. The only thing he understands is our positive reinforcement, which consists of a slap to the back of the head, a punch to the face, a gouge to the eyes. It doesn't matter. Whatever it takes for him to do what we tell him, that's exactly what we're going to do.
Is all this necessary? I don't agree with your methods.
Well, first of all, Raymond, I don't care what you agree with. You're an announcer. I'm a manager. Yes, it's necessary, because the only thing this savage understands is being hit in the head.
Oh, look, it's the red one.
Wait a minute. Wait. What is this guy? He's got the nerve to come out here during my time.
Reverend, I'm sorry. This time slot was allotted for Kamala.
Get him out of here.
Listen, brother.
Get out of here.
I understand that, and I know I don't have any business being out here, but I've been in
in the back listening, and I just can't sit by and listen to this man talk all this trash. Let me tell you something, Harvey Whippleman. You call this man a savage? You call this man a wild animal? A beast? Well, let me tell you something. He's not an animal. He's a man.
Tell him,
he's a human being. And I wouldn't treat a dog the way you've been treating this man. He doesn't need to be kicked or stoked, but this man needs to be treated with some kindness and some human compassion. And let me tell you something, Harvey. You better heed my words, because they are the message of light.
We don't need to hear this goofing. Get him out of here. We're leaving. Come on.
Hey, they want to hear the truth. If you know where your bread is buttered, you better go with Whippleman. Oh, come on.
In the Royal Rumble, 30 of the top World Wrestling Federation superstars, yeah, in the Royal Rumble, with the winner, only one winner, being able to go against the WWF champion in Las Vegas at WrestleMania, and that's gonna be the Macho Man Randy Savage. Oh yeah, it's gonna be me. Can you dig it?
Oh yes, the Royal Rumble. I just love mass burials.
The winner of the Rumble gets a chance at the most coveted prize in sport. I get 29 new souls.
Oh, he's back again. He's everywhere, antagonizing the paying customers, Brain.
What's he doing? He's talking to the kids.
Yeah. Kids didn't look too happy, did they?
Team contest.
They haven't got him down yet.
One fall.
Well, the list keeps getting bigger and bigger for the Royal Rumble. Earthquake and Crush, along with Papa Shango, Rick Martel,
and
the King, Jerry Lawler, and Carlos Colon, the Caribbean champion. It's going to be a tremendous Royal Rumble.
And it's going to be brother versus brother. When the Steiners, Rick and Scott, take on the Beverly Brothers, Bo and Blake. And you know something amazing? Rick Steiner and Scott Steiner here, both were All-Americans in Michigan.
They certainly were, Brian.
Then again, Wimbledon could be All-American in Michigan.
When you stop. You can bet that the Steiners will be tuned in next Saturday morning for the debut of WWF Mania, as will millions around the world.
I'm going to watch it. I want to see Razor Ramon do a number on Owen Hart again.
Well, Hitman wasn't too happy about that, Brain.
Tough.
Rick and Scott here invading the WWF, because this is where the prestige, where the gold is. This is where the Million Dollar Man and Irwin are, and they want what they've got.
Well, they rule the roost, Money Inc. You know, I've heard a long time about the Steiners. How big they are, how tough they are, how bad they are, how unpredictable they are. Well, I want to just see for myself. I'm glad they're here now.
Well, shut your mouth and watch them.
You shut up. You know, it's so cold here. It makes sense to me why Rick Steiner's wearing earmuffs.
Did you see that, Bray? Did you see that beautiful gut-wrench suplex?
Yeah, I saw it.
Ooh, earmuffs? What are you talking about?
Put earmuffs on.
Earlier on, we had a chance to talk to Rick and Scott.
You know, the WWF is a lot uncharted waters for my brother and I. There's a new sea of sharks out there. Well, me and my brother got something to prove.
You know, Beverly Brothers, in the Royal Rumble, you're gonna find out what the Steiner Brothers are all about.
And they won't like it. Can you imagine raising those two?
Quickly over the top. Oh, look at that. Caught him in midair for that power slam.
That impressed me. That impressed me. Because I can flash back and remember when I used to use that.
Are you serious? Tremendous athletes. Great tag team partners. Each one knows what the other one is thinking, Brian. That's what makes them great. Oh, turn me loose.
Well, I know what you're thinking all the time.
You do, huh? If you knew that, you'd double your life insurance.
What do you mean?
Forget about it.
Uh-oh.
Oh, elevator up!
Oh, no.
Keep your eye on the bouncy ball.
Oh! Oh, I'm going to get on the phone with Jimmy Hart.
Yeah, you better have a talk to Bo and Blake.
Oh, Hitman, Razor understands you're a little upset because I slapped your little brother around. It's personal now, Chico. Yo, Bret Hart at the Rumble. Chico, you're next.
Let me tell you something, Razor Ramon. This won't be the first time that I'll have to pound out some bully for picking on one of my little brothers. But let me explain something to you, Chico. When you step in the ring with me, the excellence of execution in the Royal Rumble, I'm going to show you that I'm not just a good wrestler, that I'm a tough fighter, and I'm going to pound the daylights out of you.
Features here this week on Primetime, Intercontinental title up for grabs. The challenger making his way down. Bobby the Brain Heenan. I think Skinner is going to give the champ Brain a run for the money.
Oh, I'm well aware of that. Because Skinner's a tough customer. He is really tough.
Doesn't have a whole lot of money tied up in ring attire, does he?
Doesn't need any.
I guess not.
I guess those are his play clothes.
That's enough of the frogs and stuff. Opportunity indeed for Razor Ramon in Sacramento, California on January 24th, part of the big Royal Rumble. He gets a crack at reigning WWF champion Bret the Hitman Hart for all the marbles.
This is going to be a heck of a match right here.
Let me propose this little scenario.
Listen to that.
The chant is for Marty Jannetty. That's the match they want to see. Was saying, Brian, let me propose this little scenario to you. Suppose that at the Royal Rumble in Sacramento, Razor Ramon becomes the WWF champion, and also suppose that Ric Flair wins the 30-man over-the-top battle royal. That would mean that Ric Flair would have to face Razor Ramon at WrestleMania 9
at Caesar's Palace in Las Vegas.
So what?
So what?
Yeah.
I'm sure he's aware of that. Flair doesn't have any friends.
What would you call that, a no-lose situation?
For who?
For you.
I have no financial ties with Razor Ramon.
That's a lie.
I do not. Every time they get paid, you get paid.
No.
And that's what Mr. Perfect didn't like about it.
I don't know where you heard that.
I heard it from Mr. Perfect.
Well, they're competitors. They know what it's all about. They just have to get in there and go at it.
Oh, look at this beautiful reverse. And another counter. Oh, look at the moves. Look at that. What a shot to the kisser. Pretty boy got hit right in the mush.
I'll tell you something, a guy like Skinner, as tough as this man is, he loves to get his hands on a guy that looks this good. He likes to put bruises and welts all over him.
And Shawn Michaels doesn't like it one bit.
No, he doesn't.
Oh, look at that spinning neck breaker by the Alligator Man. I thought perhaps he might have gone there for his alligator neck breaker. You know, you get a chance like this very seldom, because a guy like Skinner, even with his impressive win record, get an opportunity to become Intercontinental Champion, and Harry's getting it right here on Primetime Wrestling. Shoulder breaker of beauty.
But see, he's wasting too much time.
Two count only, says the referee. Elbow finds the mark, and Shawn is out of there.
See, Skinner's taking too much time.
Well, what's he going to do now? The other guy's out of the ring.
Get him and throw him back in and pulverize him. That's how you win titles. No, he must have heard me.
Skinner right out to the floor. Skinner right into that steel post.
See, Skinner doesn't care about his looks. He is just one tough customer.
Skinner trying to get back in there in the worst way. Doesn't want to get counted out of this one. I believe Shawn Michaels is just realizing right now, Brain, that he's got a tiger by the tail.
Or an alligator by the tail.
Oh, standing drop kick. Just a grazing blow, but still enough to send the Alligator Man down to the canvas. Irish whip, but reversed by Skinner. Oh, there's nobody there.
Oh, yes, there is.
There he is. Skinner got a little finesse, Brain.
Look at this. Marty Jannetty to hold him back anymore.
What are you talking about?
Well, they were never WWF Tag Team Champions.
Marty Jannetty, when they were partners, was the strength of that team.
Oh, he was not. He held this man down.
Are you kidding?
See, Skinner keeps throwing him out. Skinner's used to fighting in those alligator-infested places they hang out, I guess. I don't know.
Swamp shop.
Swamp shop. Yeah, I guess. But, I mean, he's got to take it to him.
Look at this. Hooks the leg. Two.
He got him.
Well, putting one out of the Alligator Man.
Welcome back, everyone, to the very last segment of the very last show of Primetime. And we certainly would like to take this opportunity to thank you for your support through the years, and we certainly hope you have enjoyed some of the more memorable moments of past prime times. And we certainly do invite you to join us next Monday night, live from New York, from the Manhattan Center. It's going to be Monday Night Raw, Gorilla.
The Big Apple. You couldn't have picked a better spot, Vince.
Well, and then again, some of us are real happy about it, and some of us aren't.
I'll be there.
You will?
I'll be there. I may take... You said anything can happen.
There's no question about that.
It's live.
Yep. Speaking of...
Oh, no.
Hey,
Jameson, how are you?
Good.
Yeah, how are you, pal?
Good. So this is the last show.
The last show, Jameson.
I got a present, a special presentation for Bobby.
I don't want anything from you. I told you that.
It's an award.
I don't want to.
It's an award.
Award.
As if you're going to win an award?
Yeah, because like,
he has it.
You said you wanted an Emmy, remember? But we couldn't get you an Emmy, but we got you a corny. Yeah, because for you, you're the corniest guy on television.
Corn on the cob, and look.
Yeah.
Yeah. Where have you had that?
My jacket.
I got don't think so, pal.
Too, if you want that.
What is it?
Macaroni.
Get this guy out of here.
What? Let's be nice to him now. Are you getting sick? Bobby the Brain Heenan is running for cover. Join us.
Welcome to WWF Superstars. Vince McMahon here along with the King, Jerry Lawler, and the Macho Man, Randy Savage. And look who's headed to the ring.
Kamala, and he's definitely in a state of confusion after last week. River and Slick, but I've been in a state of confusion before, so I can't blame him for that.
You heard, King, exactly what Reverend Slick said to Kamala. He said, Kamala, you are a man.
He's adding to the confusion. I remember when Kamala was thinking right back in his native country. He wrote a book called How to Serve Your Fellow Man. It was a cookbook. That's when he was thinking right. He's trying to confuse him now.
Well, I definitely don't want to go to dinner with Kamala, but I'm thinking that he's probably thinking of a different light at the end of the tunnel, and it's not following the King, Jerry Lawler, so to speak.
I don't know about that. Seems to me Kim Shee and Harvey Whippleman have been put on notice by
that?
Reverend Slick. Indeed, we have. The treatment of Kamala has been abominable.
How can you say that? That's what this man needs. He needs to be whipped into shape. He needs to be driven in order to beat those opponents that he's going to be going against. He needs somebody, a driving force behind him. That's all Kim Shee's doing.
Oh, Reverend Slick could do that. You know, just being a man type of situation is like graduating college, yeah.
I don't know about that right now. Look at that kick by Kamala. Kamala pretty much manhandling Todd Becker. You won't see too much here in the way of scientific maneuvering on the part of the Ugandan giant. But the maneuvering he does do is very effective.
That's right, and the reason he's doing so well right now was because of the treatment he received right before he went in the ring from Kim Shee. That's what that man needs.
Let me tell you something about the Ugandan giant. Look at that guy on the outside of the ring. You think that's helping the Ugandan giant?
Sure.
I don't think so.
All he needs to do is reach through the ropes and slap him right in the teeth.
Oh, I don't think Harvey Whippleman should do that. I think
a hard right hand, a chop, and down again goes Todd Becker. Instructions being shouted by Kim Shee to the Ugandan giant, the mighty Kamala. Off the rope, double chop, and look out! Oh, yeah! Forget about it!
Unbelievable. Put him over the other way. Kamala, you can't get a pinfall that way.
Kamala still confused. Uh-oh. Still confused as to exactly how to pin a man.
That's what I'm trying to tell you. All Harvey Whippleman and Kim Shee are doing is giving this man instructions, helping him to win his matches.
The science of wrestling by the King, Jerry Lawler. We all appreciate your input.
You should.
I don't.
And again, we see Kim Shee and Harvey Whippleman instructing Kamala, giving him a few pointers, apparently. Kamala peering down on his... Ooh, look at that.
That's abuse.
Like
that's abuse right
there. It's not. It's what he needs. Look at his face. That's all he understands.
Push him against the wall one time.
Just as Reverend Slick said last week, Kamala's not an animal. But he's being treated as an animal. Come on.
He is a man. He won't take that much longer.
Hey, bro, wait a minute. Here comes Reverend Slick.
What business does he have out here now?
Here he comes. Look at this. Reverend Slick!
crowd is coming in.
Ringside, Raymond Rougeau apparently will attempt to pick up an interview from the crowd to find out what another crowd will heed last week's warning from Crush.
Hey, Mr. Perfect. I heard you're asking questions of the other wrestlers. Hey, who is this guy, Narcissus? What do you know about him? Is he truly beyond perfect? Is it possible for anyone to have those qualities superior to mine? Well, let me answer your questions, Mr. Perfect. Comparing you to Narcissus would be like comparing ice cream to horse manure. Now, I know horse manure has its place in this world. Even perfect horse manure. But perfect, there is only room in this world for one human being that is truly anatomically perfect, that is physically and mentally superior beyond imagination. Why, Ric Flair and I both agree that Michelangelo could not capture on canvas the stupendous qualities of Narcissus. He could not sculpt from marble the metamorphic qualities of Narcissus. Why, Narcissus is so beyond perfect, it's like he's from another galaxy. So, Mr. Perfect, when you see me unveil Narcissus at the Royal Rumble, you are going to think, if you can, that Narcissus is from another world.
For weeks now, I'm sure everyone here has noticed this strange clown that has been showing up in arenas all over the country. Well, we'd like to find out what this clown is made of, what is he all about, and what does he want here in the World Wrestling Federation. So let's bring out the clown.
This is going to be most interesting. Wait a minute, what's this? His arm's in a sling.
Okay, Mr. Clown, you must have a name.
Yeah, Doink.
Doink. Your name is Doink.
Yeah, Doink.
Doink. What kind of a name is Doink?
It's a good name.
Okay, I'd like to straighten out a few things here. First of all, you tripped the big boss man on his way to the ring. You put a mop in Tatanka's eye. You threw water on Marty Jannetty.
Ah, you needed a bath anyway. Oh, don't forget the bananas underneath Beckham's feet.
You know, you're the only one laughing here. Clowns are supposed to be funny. Clowns are supposed to make children laugh. I don't see anybody laughing but you.
Hey, isn't that what it's all about? I just love to come out to the arenas and look around and look at all the little kids' faces. They're all smiling. They're all jumping up and down. They're all wondering what Doink's going to do next. And I love to go up to them and play with them, give them little balloons, give them little tricks, do little tricks for them. And then I like to look at them and their little smiles. And I like to just take those smiles right away.
Oh, that's despicable. As a matter of fact, didn't Crush give you a severe warning last week right here? Now, it's one thing to pull your practical jokes on wrestlers who can defend themselves, but it's another thing to pull your pranks on these youngsters out here.
Hey, I'm having a good time. I'm laughing. I'm having a good time.
Well, you're the only one that's having a good time. You know what the bottom line is? Your jokes are always at someone else's expense.
You know what? I don't care if these are little kids' expenses. I don't care if it's those people's up there expenses or those people's up there expenses. As a matter of fact, I don't even care if they're your expense. Yeah.
Look at this. Look at this. You think that's funny too, I suspect.
That must be your court gesture, King Jerry Lawler, right there.
He would make a great one. He abuses me.
I don't know how this clown hurt his arm. As far as I'm concerned, he's hurt enough feelings around here, that's for sure. This guy's sick.
No, he's
yeah,
funny.
Yeah, no, he's sick.
I don't like him.
I don't either.
I do.
You know, nobody has been more undeserving of an Intercontinental title shot than you, Marty Jannetty. But being Mr. Cool, I'm going to give you one anyway. And everybody wants to know, where's Sherry going to be? Whose corner is she going to be in? Well, I mean, I haven't had a chance to talk to her. But like any woman, she's going to be in the Heartbreak Kids corner. You can count on that. Jannetty, Royal Rumble, you're done.
January 24th, the Royal Rumble. I'm going to call it Marty Jannetty Day, because that's the day I'm going to get everything I want. I'm going to capture the Intercontinental Championship. And more than that, I'm going to end the career of you, Shawn Michaels. And you talking about Sherry being in your corner, you know all about Sherry. Well, maybe you don't know Sherry as well as you think you do.
Talking about having a good time, talking about a smile on the face of Mr. Perfect. No, it doesn't look out of place, because the Royal Rumble is here. An opportunity for Mr. Perfect, a guy who has no problems with anything, because everything in my life is perfect. And all the great athletes that enter the Royal Rumble, no matter how big and how strong and how powerful and how smart you are, one thing you're not, and that's perfect.
Oh! Hey, folks, it's Royal Rumble time! Hacksaw Jim Duggan's kind of match. Because of that moves, you nail it. No friend, all foes out there. I want to tell you folks one thing. I'm not going to guarantee I win the match, but I guarantee I'll give you 110%. Tough guy.
The Royal Rumble. 29 men. That's 29 minds and 29 souls that Papa Shango will possess. Beware, everyone, because after I win, I will have the shot at the title.
Bam Bam Bigelow, you're a big, tough, rough-looking guy, and scaring me to death with all them tattoos on your head. You know, I've dealt with trash like you all my life, boy, and all them punks are still behind bars. The plain simple fact is, in Royal Rumble, I'm gonna teach you a little lesson about hard times, law, order, and justice, big boss man style.
Hello, everyone. I'm Sean Mooney. A few minutes ago, it was a mob scene out here, everyone braving the elements to be a part of Monday Night Raw. But now they're inside set for the action. Hey, wait a minute.
What?
Bobby Heenan.
I'm going in there.
No.
Yes, I am.
You were replaced.
I was replaced?
Yes.
By who? Would replace me?
Rob Bartlett. You're not
I don't care about Rob Bartlett. This is Monday Night Raw, live from New York City.
That's
and
right.
I've got to be in there to host it.
No, you're not.
No, what do you mean,
no? You can't get in. I'm sorry.
What do you mean, I can't get in? I can get in. I can buy a ticket.
No, there are no tickets left. It's sold out in there. They're jammed to the rafters.
Well, then show me the press gate so I can get through here.
I didn't make up the rules here. I didn't.
What do you mean, Unicorn?
This contest is scheduled for one fall. Coming down the aisle from Union City, Tennessee, weighing 228 pounds, the Birdman, Hunko, Beware!
On Monday Night Raw, go get him, Birdman!
You know, I often wondered whatever happened to Gary Coleman, Vince.
He grew up. There he is! And this athlete headed to the ring right now. Something else, indeed. We have never seen anything quite like Yokozuna before.
Oh, you're not kidding.
Biggest angle.
Yokozuna! Well, thus far, he is undefeated in the World Wrestling Federation. Yokozuna, meaning grand champion. Mr. Fuji bringing Yokozuna, former sumo wrestler, into the WWF. He really has a combination of all of the martial arts.
Nobody
I think Yoko
has
should
knock them off his feet, Bartlett.
Yeah, I can't say the same for Rob, but that's all right.
Yoko should spend a little less time at the sushi bar, a little more time at the salad bar, Vince.
Well, we'll see about that. All that weight Yokozuna uses to his advantage here. And as the Macho Man said, he has thus far not even been knocked off his feet, much less undefeated.
He hasn't seen his feet in quite some time.
Well, that's a good point as well.
Oh, my God.
And yes, take a look. Oh, my.
This guy's got his own no-fly zone.
No, that's not right. He doesn't even have a zipper. You got to understand that.
Take a look. 505 pounds. Yokozuna.
That's one big-butted Oriental, Vince.
In a matter of speaking, yes. Also.
He's got an ass like an amphitheater.
Woo! I heard that.
This is Monday Night Raw, folks. It's uncooked.
Uncut.
And uncensored. Yeah.
We are live from New York City.
Look at that wedgie he's got going.
If you told me he weighed 1,000 pounds, I would tend to believe you.
He is all business in the ring. You can make fun of him all you want. His opponents do not.
He's got his own gravitational pull.
Let me tell you something. He's going against a real tough guy in Coco Beware. He doesn't have Frankie with him. I wonder if that'll be a factor.
Yeah, where is Frankie?
I have no idea.
Yokozuna had a little snack before he came out.
What it would be, a little snack to him.
Hey, Vince, don't regulations indicate that Yokozuna should be wearing a bra?
Not here in the World Wrestling Federation, and certainly not on Monday Night Raw. Anything goes.
He can wrestle, but he can't walk the beats.
I imagine this man could do almost anything he wants to do.
What you talking about, Yoko?
Mr. Fuji, bowing with a nod of approval. And by the way, Yokozuna is headed to the Royal Rumble, as you are as well, Macho Man.
You bet, and I bet you when you get him in the ring, it's going to be hard to put the 29 other guys in there, too.
Yeah, not much room, much less. How are you going to get a big man like that out? Look at this, Coco Beware, shoved back to the corner.
I've never seen Coco Beware thrown so easily before. I'm thinking that he's going to have to get up and make a better account for himself right now.
Coco, quite a competitor. Coco normally in tag team fashion, joining Owen Hart as high energy. Oh, look at that.
Coco, stay down.
Yeah, I
guess. Do yourself a favor, babe.
No, he's a fighter. He's a fighter. He'll get there.
Unfortunately, Coco's tag team partner, Owen Hart, suffering a bit of an injury at the hands of Razor Ramon recently.
And Razor Ramon's going against Bret Hart for the world title. Little history there.
And later on, as we stated, we will have a special interview with the number one contender to meet Bret Hart at the Royal Rumble, Razor Ramon. But right now, Coco Beware must figure out Yokozuna. If you're Coco, Macho Man, what do? Obviously, you don't try the power.
It's too late to leave the building and leave the arena and leave the state and leave the country because everybody's watching you live. So you got to
work out. Kick. Everybody do it.
No.
Another one.
It's like trying to stop a battleship with a slingshot.
He staggered him. Coco's hurt.
Coco, be aware, with a gallant effort a moment ago. And
you better watch it.
No.
Is that a butt drop?
I don't know what it is.
He can name it anything he wants right there. Unbelievable.
Apparently, there's no Japanese word for leftover, Vince.
I suppose not. Coco, beware, suffering the effect of that leg drop by a 505-pounder just a moment ago. Come on, ref, get in there. Blatant chokehold. Coco, back to the buckle. And uh-oh. Wait a minute now. Yokozuna with a head of steam. Here he comes. Oh! Forget about it. Coco, beware, down on the canvas. Get up from there.
No, please don't.
Get up from there, Coco. You better be moving out of the way.
Coco.
There's about to be an earthquake here in New York City.
Busting!
Oh, no. My goodness.
Record players just skipped in Guam.
Yes.
You could slide Coco Beware under the dressing room door right now.
Yokozuna, victorious. With momentum, he heads to the Royal Rumble, one of the 30 participants in the over-the-top Royal Rumble, the winner of which meets the champion, whomever he may be, the WWF champion at WrestleMania. Right now, let's go back and take another look. Yokozuna, but take a look at this. All right, Rob, do you think?
I think if he just skipped a few lunches, we wouldn't need to do that headlock on hunger.
Yeah,
that's the squashola.
Yokozuna, quite a performer, on his way to Sacramento, California for the Rumble.
Yes, Vince, I'm not quite sure what is going on. Apparently, a security guard has detained a woman here. Excuse me, sir. What seems to be the problem here?
Wait, your nephew? I'm supposed to see him, yes.
You're Rob Bartlett's aunt?
Yes, I'm his aunt. He's my nephew. He's my, yes. I have to go in there and see him
I'm sure we can straighten this all out.
He's
we could probably go into the Wilk call.
I'm going in there right now.
Wait a minute. Bobby Heenan.
Give me that.
I thought I'd seen everything here in the World Wrestling Federation, but the brain in drag.
I gotta get in there.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, here he is, Razor Ramon.
Yeah.
You're headed to the Royal Rumble. This is the golden opportunity you've been waiting for. Meeting the Hitman Bret Hart for the WWF Championship. Are you ready? You're less than 2 weeks away.
Look at me, man. I was born ready, Chico. And when you say golden opportunity, that's got Razor Ramon written all over it.
I see, but nonetheless, you certainly will recall that it took the Hitman Bret Hart 8.5 long years climbing the ladder of success to gain the momentum he has. And you're sort of a Johnny come lately, if you'd pardon the expression.
Hey, look, Hitman, 8.5 years, Chico, you climb to the very, very top. You're the main man in the WWF. Now say hello to Razor Ramon. 8.5 months and I caught you. I am numero uno.
All right,
the
you're the
number one contender.
Yes, indeed, the number one contender. And if you're the number one contender and such a great competitor, why did you do to Owen Hart what you did? Why jump him? Well, come on.
Hey, silencio.
He was the best wrestler around, and
Razor
Ramon. There with him.
Obviously, your father was a big influence on you and on Bret.
Your Hitman, squashing your little brother like a cockroach. That was fun, man. And you know what else? There's nothing you can do about it. Not, Chico, that you don't want to do nothing about it, because you can't do nothing about it.
Thank you very much for joining us.
Wait. And Hitman, you know what else you can't do nothing about? Chico, you can't do nothing about Razor Ramon taking your precious gold at the Royal Rumble.
It'll head your way, ladies and gentlemen, in less than 2 weeks, Sunday afternoon. He's a bad guy.
Razor Ramon's talking pure garbage, but let me tell you that something that's pure gold. The WWF and the Red Cross team.
The following contest, scheduled for one fall, is for the Intercontinental Championship.
That's Tatanka, by the way.
About to enter the ring is the challenger.
The name for Buffalo, right?
38 pounds, Max.
Indeed.
Boone.
Here we go. It's Robo Wrestler.
Max Boone, quite a competitor. This is a tremendous opportunity for Max Boone.
Here from New York City, where you could wear an outfit like that in the subway and not get a second look.
Well, he's got a chance to win the Intercontinental title right now.
He certainly does.
Macho Man, I never thought you'd be underdressed, but next to this guy.
Looks like Matt Masterson to me. Vince McMahon, looks like the riverboat gambler.
Oh, my goodness.
240 pounds. Here's a man who gambles all right in a very calculated manner. Shawn Michaels. We are live, ladies and gentlemen, from the man. Center in New York City, Shawn Michaels defending the Intercontinental Championship against Max Boone. And you might say that Shawn Michaels has somewhat of an ego as far as the ladies are concerned.
He's a legend in his own mind.
Yes.
Nonetheless, thus far, no one has been able to take away the Intercontinental Championship from Shawn Michaels' nice arm drag. And you have to give this young man credit in terms of his athleticism.
He's a great athlete, no doubt about it. Right in
and
front
he knows it, and he wants everyone else to know it.
Don't forget, folks, coming up soon, the WWF's version of the Amy Fisher story, Pin Me.
Oh, really?
Starring the sensational Sherry as Amy, Vince McMahon as Joey Buttafuoco,
and Bobby the Brain Heenan as Mary Jo.
I think he just did a Rebecca Heenan out there, didn't he, in the
streets?
I don't
know about that.
I'm telling you, she looked nice.
And to the ropes here, Max Moon back up on his feet as well. Look at this. A lunge back off the rope. Shawn Michaels now underneath the legs and, oh, nice maneuver by Max Moon. Another arm drag takedown. And these two competitors mean business here at the Manhattan Center. And Michaels takes a powder. A little time to get himself together here and figure all this out.
He's on Raw, Monday Night Raw right there, and he's uncensored.
And uncut.
And uncooked.
Shawn Michaels looks to have a little problem figuring out Max Moon. I think Moon might even be a shade quicker than Shawn Michaels.
So far, that's true. But time will tell.
Will Shawn be part of that Royal Rumble there, Vince?
Again, just like the Macho said, time will tell. Oh, yeah!
Awesome!
Right into the hammerlock. Nicely done. Thus far, it seems to me Max Moon is sort of outclassing Shawn Michaels.
This is where you can make a name for yourself real
big time.
Stay tuned later on here, folks, live from New York City. Mayor David Dinkins versus Cardinal O'Connor.
Time permitting, of course. Well, wait a minute, now we're told that we're gonna have to take a quick break. We'll be right back as the match continues. Stay with us. We are coming to you from New York City's Manhattan Center live. It's Monday Night Raw. Vince McMahon with Rob Bartlett and the Macho Man Randy Savage. And this matchup continues for the Intercontinental Championship. Max Moon squaring up against Shawn Michaels. Look at that.
What a match we're watching right here. It's unbelievable. It's fantastic.
You missed it during the break, folks. Shawn Michaels pulled a knife.
Stop it, Rob.
I'm sorry.
It's not that raw, but it is uncut.
Uncensored.
And uncooked.
And look at this, what a maneuver by Shawn Michaels.
A knife would have been nicer right there.
That was uncouth.
Yeah, definitely. Shawn Michaels will do anything to retain his WWF Championship. Shawn Michaels headed to the Royal Rumble, defending the title if he is successful here against Marty Jannetty. Sensational Sherry is scheduled to be at ringside, but we don't know in whose corner she's going to be in.
Maybe both corners.
Yeah.
Little split personality thing going on there, and
possible. She's the toughest one of the bunch, maybe.
By the way, in this day and age of pardons, WWF President Jack Tunney attempting to pardon Mike Tyson recently, unable to do so, but we understand Mr. Tyson has a monitor and a telephone, and he's watching Monday Night Raw.
Perhaps. Hello? Hello, Vince?
Is that Mike? Is that you?
Yeah, hi, how you doing?
That's Mike Tyson.
Yeah, I'm here. I'm in solitary confinement.
You're where?
I'm in solitary confinement.
Well, we're here at Monday Night Raw.
By myself, I might add.
Well, all right. That makes some sense.
Used to have fun on dates, but now you're making license plates. Isn't that right, Mike?
1-2 and almost a count of three. We certainly hope, Mr. Tyson, you're enjoying Monday Night Raw.
Oh, this is nothing. I see this kind of stuff in the mess hall every day.
Oh, well, I don't know about that.
Hey, who's that on the screen now? Is that Oprah Winfrey?
No, there's no telling what you're going to see here on Monday Night Raw. That's the Doink.
Doink.
And it looks like Shawn Michaels is taking over on Max Moon. Mike, by the way, any New Year's resolutions from you, Mr. Tyson?
No, just that I want to make sure I don't miss that Royal Rumble. The tag team between Deadly Diana and Fabulous Fergie versus the Prince Brothers, Chuck and Andy.
That's not this year's Royal Rumble, Mike. That's next year.
Oh, he's nice. Who's he?
This face has broken so many homes, so many.
Oh, give me a break. We said before he stuck on himself.
That face makes me break wind. I don't know about you.
Jeez, Mike. What do they feed you there?
I'm going to be in here for another 6 years. Although my manager, Mr. King, is going to try to reduce the sentence to like 72 months.
It seems like he's been reducing your bank account. Oh,
whoa, 2 and almost a count of 3. I don't know about that either. Shawn Michaels, the aggressor at the moment against Max Moon. Michaels wanting to head to the Royal Rumble to defend the title against his former tag team partner, Marty Jannetty. You have to wonder what factor, if any. Wait, here's another cover. 2 and almost 3. What sort of a factor Sensational Sherry will be in the matchup at the Royal Rumble?
Absolutely. And you know, you got a lot of important people out here in the audience. Did you know that, Vince McMahon? You got
Tito
Landrum. Tito, that's right. Tito Landrum with the Baltimore Orioles is here, and everybody that's anybody, yeah.
Uh-huh.
Hey, I got a question.
Yes, Mike.
What do you call this thing he's doing to him there now?
Mike? Sort of a reverse chin lock.
That's something that Buster Douglas didn't do to you in that bad night.
He tried, though.
Yeah, he tried.
I think that'll come in handy in the yard one of these days.
Exactly. Hey, listen, you got a raw deal. We'll tell you right there on Monday Night Raw that you got a raw deal when you ended up where you are now.
Some people say he did. Whoa, what a maneuver there by Max Boone. Max Boone trying to get, look at that, all the way over the top rope. Unbelievable.
Where'd he go? He's gone.
Shawn Michaels may be history.
He disappeared.
Look at this, Max Boone was going to come out on him as well, and Michaels, he does it. Whoa, unbelievable maneuver on the part of Max Boone. What a high-risk maneuver that was. Max Boone wants to be Intercontinental Champion, and look at Michaels back off.
Marty Jannetty might have to go after Max Boone at the Royal Rumble.
Uppercut by Max Boone. And Michael's having his problems to the buckle. Oh, my goodness.
Oh, look out. Carefully, you missed the dinky.
I beg your pardon?
Something. Oh.
There we go. Has him in the cradle. Two and no. So very, very close.
When does Max show his moves, Vince?
He just did, I think, in a matter of speaking. Ooh. Max Boone, a miss. Look at that, Salon kick right on the button.
That was a home run.
Yeah. Shawn Michaels turning the tide right back around now. But look out, this one's not over yet. Suplex. Nicely executed. Cover, maybe he gets him.
Oh. Oh.
History. A valiant effort by Max Boone. But Shawn Michaels is still the Intercontinental Champion.
And still, Intercontinental Champion, Shawn Michaels.
Shawn Michaels heads to the Royal Rumble Women's Championship intact. You're watching Monday Night Raw live from New York, and you can also watch WWF Mania.
There is no more room inside, but the word is out. These folks are lining up to get tickets for next week's Monday Night WWF Raw. Excuse me, sir. I just want to ask you a question. Are you getting your tickets for next week?
I got to get in line here.
Get in line?
Yes, I got to get inside there. I got to see.
Fuck. What's the problem?
I got to see my nephew. His name is Ron Bartlett.
You have a relation.
Yes,
there.
I'm Uncle Morty Feldman. He needs me inside. I got to go now.
I ran into your
inside.
Wife earlier. Wait a minute. No.
I've got to go inside.
What are you talking?
I have to. He's got the tickets for me for tonight for the Raw on discount. He's got the discount. He's a good bagel. He's a good boy.
Wait a minute. Uncle Morty, you seem to be having a little problem here with your beard. Bobby Heenan.
Okay, you know. I got to get inside.
Well, I'll
go to any lengths. I got to get inside. I got to get in there. I got to. No, please, you understand. I got to get the roof. Fiddler, the roof.
The Giant still chasing his former manager, Harvey Whippleman and Kim Chi. And wait a minute, for whom the bell tolls.
This guy looks like he got his hair cut during a power surge.
Well, at least he's using his real name. From the outer reaches of your mind. That's no place to be from. And take a look, ladies and gentlemen. The Phenom, known as the Undertaker.
Get your hair out of your face. You have such a pretty face.
We are live from New York City. And by the way, we'd like to thank the good folks over at WFAN Radio here in New York for allowing us to have Rob Bartlett here at ringside. We certainly would like to thank that media icon, Don Imus, winner of the prestigious Marconi Award and former governor of the state of Connecticut for a day, for allowing Rob to be here with us.
Who's the guy with the martini shaker, Vince?
Well, you've been working with him for some time. You don't know who that is? Take a look. Who does he remind you of?
That's Paul Bearer from the famous Bearer family. He could use an iron supplement. It looks a little pale.
There's not a whole lot of sun here in New York.
All these tall buildings around and stuff.
He's definitely earned the right to be the Undertaker's manager.
Whoa! Sure. Damian Demento! Look at this. Right in the chops! A hard right in. Another one! Look at that! Right in the chops! Damian Demento backing the Undertaker up. Has him rolling now. Off the rope and... Whoa! My!
Oh, wow.
Well, I guess we kind of reverse things there, at least momentarily. And Paul Bearer certainly likes what he sees. I think Paul should think about going to a decaffeinated brand, Vince. He's doing very well for himself these days, Paul Bearer is, and for that matter, so is The Undertaker, who likewise will join Randy Savage, Yokozuna, and a whole bunch of competitors competing in the Royal Rumble. Oh, ah, in less than 2 weeks.
Undertaker walking tall right there.
He always walks tall. Demento having his problems. Undertaker's all over Damian Demento.
Two big names in the World Wrestling Federation on Monday Night Raw going head to head.
Demento to the buckle. Thus far, other than the shots Demento got in earlier, now things may just be reversed a bit. By the way, next week, ladies and gentlemen, here on Monday Night Raw, you'll want to join us as we come to you live again from the Manhattan Center. If you can't make it down here, we do invite you to tune in. Mr. Perfect will square off against Papa Shango, El Matador, to meet Ric Flair, plus in a special interview, the reigning WWF champion, the Hitman himself, the Hitman Bret Hart will be here. Ooh, way up there. You know, he wears those gloves so he doesn't get those dishpan hands. I don't think he's worried about that, but look out, here it comes down. The Undertaker with the middle, down with the tombstone. That could be it.
Oh my, yes.
Get the body bag.
Here is your
The Undertaker
winner.
Victorious. And again, we invite you to join us next week. Mr. Perfect here, El Matador, Ric Flair, Papa Shango, the Hitman, Bret Hart, and by the way, yes, we're back with
Doink, ladies and gentlemen, here on Monday Night Raw, and Doink likes to make children cry, not laugh, and Crush has warned you about that.
He warned me about what?
Making children cry.
Hey, if they don't have a sense of humor, that's their problem. If I laugh, that's all that matters.
So you're not going to heed the warning of Crush, then?
Let me tell you, if he came out here right now, he would be crying, too. And I would be laughing.
Oh, wait. Excuse me, Mr. Doink. I'd like for you to meet Crush. Pardon me, Crush. Who's laughing now?
Hey, bro. Before you put your size 14 shoe in your size 20 mount, you better look over both shoulders, bro. You got that? This was just a warning, bro. If I catch you touching anyone else, playing your stupid jokes that only you're laughing at on anyone else, brah, you just might be wearing a cast on both arms and both legs next time. You got that, brother?
Whoa. Whoa.
As you know, Bobby Heenan has been very persistent throughout the evening attempting to get inside. Well, I've got some good news for him. Excuse me, Bobby.
What?
Bobby
I
Heenan.
Get
I know. I just got I word. I just got word. You can go on up. You're welcome. Go. Yes, you're on the way. No, let him go. Let him go. He's have a good time up there, Bobby.
The greatest accomplishment of my entire life was winning the World Wrestling Federation title. And I knew the second that I won it that I would have to face all challenges, the biggest, the baddest, the meanest, and the toughest. And I knew that I'd have to face the treacherous ones right at the bottom of the barrel. But never did I think that you have to lift up and tilt up the barrel and find the likes of you, Razor Ramon. That unprovoked attack you did on my brother will not be forgotten. And when you step in the ring with me in the Royal Rumble, you will pay. The excellence of execution will execute you, Razor Ramon.
You know, Harvey Whippleman, it's a shame the way you and Kim T have abused this man. Well, you know, I'm not going to stand for it. Yes, I interfered. Yes, I got in your business. It's all right because you hit me. I'm a peaceful man. I won't fight back. And let me say to you people out there, this man, I want to help him to see the light just like I've seen the light. And you can help me do it. I want you to help me. I want you to embrace him. Throw your arms around him. Let's reach out to him. Let's help him to walk down the righteous path.
You know, Kamala hasn't been the same ever since The Undertaker put him in the coffin at the Survivor Series. Well, Kamala's never going to be the same after Kim Chi gets through with him. And then the WWF's never going to be the same after I drop the big bomb.
Royal Rumble to face Marty Jannetty. He is the reigning Intercontinental Champion. He calls himself the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels. He's
so sexy. Take a look at this. You have to wonder, will sensational Sherry be in Shawn Michaels' corner? Will she be in Marty Jannetty's corner? Or simply around ringside to create some havoc? Who knows?
Well, look at Shawn Michaels. You think he needs Sherry? You think he wants Sherry?
I don't know. We'll
okay,
have to find
Mr.
out.
Michael, last week it was announced that you will defend your Intercontinental Championship at Royal Rumble against Marty Jannetty. It has also been announced that sensational Sherry will be at ringside at Royal Rumble. But as of yet, we still don't know in which corner she will be.
Oh, Raymond Rougeau, I know whose corner she's going to be in. Now, if you were a woman, which could be debatable, would you be in the corner of a man who brutally and ruthlessly attacked you and beat you over the head with a mirror?
Now, wait a minute, Shawn Michaels. Everyone saw you pull Sherry.
No. You would not be in that corner. You would be in the corner of a man that you are madly and deeply and passionately in love with. And that man is Shawn Michaels. I got news for you. Sensational Sherry will be in the corner of the sexiest man alive and the World Wrestling Federation Intercontinental Champion. And as for you, Marty Jannetty, everybody knows that I am the man that carried the team. I am the man that carried you throughout your whole career. And at Royal Rumble, you are going to be carried for the last time. Carried out of the building, that is. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the Intercontinental Champion is leaving the building.
He is stuck on himself, no doubt about that. He is the Intercontinental Champion. Will he remain so after the matchup with Jannetty at the Rumble? Yes, we're all anxious for the Royal Rumble in approximately a week. And among other things, I guess we're going to see the unveiling, if you would, of this fellow Narcissus.
That's why they call Bobby the Brain. He is so smart. He is getting everybody's interest to a peak. You're wondering who it is, aren't you?
Indeed.
Look at the Macho Man. He's always just wondering.
I'm a guest.
Well, there's no wondering about this man.
competitors. The winner of the Royal Rumble will face the WWF champion at WrestleMania.
The big man from Kona, Hawaii, Russ Chakabra. Look at all the people. They know what he's all about.
Yeah, look at him. I know what he's all about, too. He's got a big smile on his face. I don't know what he's proud of. He's the man that hurt the arm of Doink, the funniest clown that I've ever seen in my life.
I don't know about that, but I know several weeks ago, the big man, Crush, was warning Doink about his practical jokes.
That's when he did it. He was twisting his arm as he warned him.
Yeah, well, I don't think anyone would want to see Doink fooling around with the kids around ringside. And I don't think Doink is going to be anywhere around this particular matchup here. Although they saw him earlier in the Nasty Boys matchup. Crush tying up his opposition now. Oh, look at this.
Surfboard move there.
Look in the background there.
Beg your pardon?
Doink, doink, way in the back there.
On the screen.
On the screen.
Wait a minute.
There he is.
I thought you said he wouldn't show up, McMahon.
I'm very surprised. Maybe he wants to have a little peace offering here with Crush. We had an occasion to speak with a big man from Kona, Hawaii about his participation in the Royal Rumble. Oh, my. Here's what he had to say.
Royal Rumble is just around the corner, brah. I tell you what, I've been training harder and more intense than ever. This is going to be Crush's day. Nobody's going to stop me, brah. I don't want to sound overconfident, but I've been training harder and stronger than ever before in my life. Royal Rumble, my day is coming, brah. Shaka.
Oh, my. I don't know too many are going to argue with Crush. W.T. Jones not putting up too much of an argument at all.
Well, I'll argue with him.
Yeah, over the telephone.
Oh, Macho Man, don't you ever get tired of having yourself around?
Well, that's your natural personality, isn't it? I'm sorry for you.
Hey, wait just a moment. Big power slam from Crush. And I think Crush just spotted Doink. He's backing off a bit.
Needs the back ball.
Yeah, I'll say. Anyone's gonna back off from this, man. Oh, look at this. Crush applying that painful submission hold. And W.T. Jones down. And W.T. Jones is having his problems at this point.
More pineapple juice for everyone. Shaka!
Crush on his way to the Royal Rumble.
Sure, he's got some powerful arms and hands. That's how he hurt Doink the Clown. He doesn't know his own strength.
Doink doesn't know about getting hurt. If Crush really wants to put a hurt, none of him could have his body in his sling.
Crush on his way. Big, powerful man. Unquestionably one of the more popular athletes here in the WWF.
Shaka.
I don't know anyone is going to get in this man's way from winning the Royal Rumble. What an event. Macho Man Randy Savage. Wait a minute.
All right.
Now, Crush warned Doink.
He's just trying to be friends.
Look, I think you're exactly right. He is. He wants to settle this thing once and for all.
Forgive and forget. Give him a flower.
As well as he should.
Smart clown.
Yeah, right. No doubt. There's no one that would not heed the advice. An admonition, if you would, from Crush.
Look at the clown's face. I hate to see a sad clown.
It's a smart clown.
The whole thing there, Paul. Wait a minute, Doink! Did you see that? Wait a minute,
his arm off!
He just took his own arm off!
Ooh.
He don't know! No! He took his own arm right out of the socket! Got it!
That's a cast!
Look what he's doing! I can't believe that! Again and again and again!
Crush is knocked out.
Stop him.
Tackle him.
Do something. What a sick man. I can't believe what he did. He's got to crush. Get him out of there. Do something. Somebody got to do something.
Well, come on, Sergeant.
I got to agree with you. That's it. That is sick. That's too much right there.
I've never seen anything like that in my life. Crush. No,
you still think that's a funny clown, King? What do you think?
That may be going a little too far.
What do you mean, maybe?
What a sick individual. Look, and Crush is still unconscious.
The clown! Could you believe that? I couldn't believe my own eyes. It looked like he took his own arm off.
That's the only way anybody could bring a big man like that down. That is the only way.
There's a harsh over this capacity crowd, I can tell you that.
And
they still can't even believe.
Unbelievable.
The EMT crew being called in, they are always in ringside. Unfortunately, for Crush, I still can't believe what we saw. Attacked from behind like that. I mean, it had to be a cast. It had to be something with some weight behind it, with Doink repeatedly hammering and hammering in the back of the head of Crush.
Crush's first impulse about that clown was correct. A flashback, a blast from the past. That clown has no business around the World Wrestling Federation. Now, I'm just hoping that the man from Kota, Hawaii is going to be okay. Not just okay for the Royal Rumble, but just, okay.
After you take a shot like...
Look at the big man
from
that's a big man laying on the ground, let me tell you.
Well, he kept hitting him. He kept hitting him from behind. He kept hitting him as hard as he possibly could. No one could stop him. He kept hitting him repeatedly. That's the sickest excuse I've ever seen for a clown. His pranks out here that we saw with the kids and whatever are one thing. His pranks against the wrestlers, something else. But this?
They're going to have trouble putting a big man like that on a stretcher right now. I'll tell you that right now. He's a very popular wrestler in the World Wrestling Federation. And King, you're not talking as much as you did before.
I think maybe. They may be concerned with his neck. Could very well be. That's what they're concerned with. I mean,
all right.
He was hit so many times in the back of the head and down in the vertebrae, the upper vertebrae. Maybe that's what they're concerned with.
They need to be careful when they move him right now. Need to be careful right there.
Okay, hold on. But I have to agree. You know, some of that stuff was funny, but this is not funny at all.
Was funny. See, won't let go, will you?
This is no laughing matter.
Yeah,
I'll
you
agree.
Just better check out and see if Crush is going to be okay. I'm going to tell you something. This is more than a rising star of the World Wrestling Federation.
They're trying to
be brought down by a goof like Doink. I'll never mention his name again. He's infamous as far as I'm concerned right now.
This is a very unfortunate incident.
Look at this.
Here in the WWF. I don't know what to say because, again, in terms of what we just saw, the most unusual antics ever since this clown, this Doink, appeared on the scene here in the WWF. And again, some of the tactics by this clown, no laughing matter until we get to this.
You're right about one thing, Vince McMahon. I'm worried about his neck. Because a big man like that, I know this guy, Crush, from Kona, Hawaii. And to put him in this position, this predicament right here, it had to be something serious.
They're trying to secure his neck. I think that's what they're trying to do now.
Is he still unconscious, or are they just trying to make sure he doesn't move?
I'm not sure.
He may still be out.
Well, you're trying to wash your hands of this situation, Lawler. You thought this was really funny.
No.
That's right, you did.
We'll be back. Let's take you to the event center.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, we've got a very important event coming up in this Royal Rumble. You got 30 of the greatest wrestlers in the World Wrestling Federation. They're all in that ring together, and they all want to be successful. They all want to get to wrestle the World Wrestling Federation title holder in WrestleMania. But I have goals of being successful also. I want that shot at WrestleMania to wrestle for the WWF title.
Well, finally, they have begun to move Crush out to the waiting ambulance. They have totally immobilized him, and he'll no doubt get the help that he needs. You can see his left hand there moving, which I believe is a very good sign.
Yeah, that is a good sign. I mean, the only thing I still worry about, though, is there's been no movement of his legs or his feet or anything, at least not that I've seen. And so many times, you know, let's face it, when you're talking about a neck injury, it's always a possibility of some sort of paralysis. And, you know, it could be from the waist down. So hopefully that's not the case.
I just can't believe that in an injury of this nature, I cannot believe what we saw. It was such sick thing for this goofy clown Doink to do. The
creep.
And then from there,
he was still laughing about it.
He laughed at it. That's exactly what he did. He laughed at it.
That, as far as I'm concerned, is unforgivable, to laugh at something like this.
You know, I think a lot of people are worried about the career of Crush right now, but I'm worried about Crush the human being right now.
Okay. Far more important than his wrestling career.
Absolutely.
A great competitor, and I don't know if you guys know him, one heck of a guy, a great guy.
Well, I don't know him personally, but you don't like to see something like this happen to anybody, no matter who it is.
We'll take you back now to Mean Gene. An unfortunate, very unfortunate incident, and hopefully next week we'll give you a further update on the condition of Crush.
That's an eerie sound right there.
Voice, tell me, who will win the World Wrestling Federation's Royal Rumble? So it has been said, and so shall it be done. I'll give you credit, Bam Bam Bigelow. You're big, tough, and rough, but take a good long look. I'm 6'7", 330 pounds, of the meanest lawman that's ever walked the face of this earth. And I'm not going to let you run roughshod over me or anybody else in the World Wrestling Federation. So in the Royal Rumble, get ready to serve hard time.
Let me call in my next guest, who will be in the Royal Rumble, Mr. Perfect.
Oh, this is an ovation. I want to see what this jerk has to say. You ingrate, you miserable lowlife. No good, backstabbing, cheating.
I'm going to call him over here, Green. Tell him you said all those things. Look at him. Does he look in great shape?
Yeah, he's in great shape.
Second ago.
You know who it was.
It was kind of hard to see. It was kind of dark over there. It's almost like there was a shadow. I guess what you're doing, Ric Flair, is walking in Mr. Perfect's shadow.
Oh, yeah. Oh, I love it. Don't get me going.
And you know what?
Oh, here we go. Oh.
Something's gonna happen. Take it easy.
Get him out of here.
Ric Flair.
See, Perfect was trying to bait him.
You want a piece of Mr. Perfect? I'm not a hard guy to find. Second of all, the winner of this year's Royal Rumble, Ric Flair, gets a shot at the World Wrestling Federation champion. And Ric Flair, this is a new year. Mr. Perfect is back in his wrestling gear for one reason, and that is to become the World Wrestling Federation champion.
You
know. I am focused, and I'm starting with the Royal Rumble.
Oh, look, he's coming back.
He's got it now. He's got it. Here we go. Here we go. Come on. Come on, Flair.
Get that chicken out.
Slaughter, take your hands off him.
Sergeant Slaughter, Rene Goulet, trying to control this. You guys lost it, Brain.
I hate him. I hate him.
He's out of control.
I hate him. I hate him.
Well, Mr. Perfect, old pal,
We're just about a week away from the Royal Rumble. And by now, Ric Flair has proved to you and to all those ham and eggers that you're anything but perfect. But just to add a little icing on the cake, after you've been dumped on your head in the Royal Rumble and beat up by 29 other wrestlers, you're going to wish you never laid eyes on me. And when I unveil Narcissus, no one will believe their eyes. This man has every right to be in love with himself. Because unlike you, Perfect, there is not, and I'll say it again, not a blemish on his body. There is not an evil backstabbing thought in his mind. He possesses the most magnificent physique known to man, with symmetry beyond being perfect, with definition a Greek god would be proud of. His muscular mass is so vast, he appears to be armor-plated. His refined good looks would compare to a mythical Adonis. So get ready, Perfect. Get ready, all you pretzel-eating, beer-guzzling, pock-marked face, couch potatoes, and wait until you see and get a load of Narcissus.
Steiner Brothers, you call yourself the new kids on the block? Well, you just moved into the wrong neighborhood.
Around here, you gotta pay your dues, Steiner Brothers. And at Royal Rumble, we're gonna beat you down and beat you down bad. Steiner Brothers, beware of the Beverly Brothers.
Yeah, the big boss man. Yeah, we all know you're big. Real big, even bigger when you got men locked up behind cages. Well, I got news for you, pal. I'm not in no cage. And at the Royal Rumble, you're gonna get a taste of me. Bam Bam Bigelow, the beast from the east.
We're only 1 week away from the Royal Rumble, and the king is really excited. That's right, the Royal Rumble. Friend against foe, friend against friend. That's what I like about it, because I don't have any friends in the WWF. They're all peasants to me. They'll bow at my feet. I'll win the Rumble, and then I'll face the WWF champion. I can't wait.
The head shrinker is coming to the Royal Rumble.
Wait a minute, what is this? Fight the real enemy. Well, I'll tell you what's happening this week.
Standing by right now, so we are told. I believe we have maybe Sean. Can you hear us?
Yes, Vince. I can hear you, Vince. After what we saw at the top of the program, I'm sure everybody's looking for Repo Man. I think I've located him. Excuse me, Repo Man. Why the unprovoked attack on the Macho Man, Randy Savage?
Because it was provoked. Was that greater one when I came behind him and hit him?
Wasn't that vicious attacks I've ever seen on a superstar?
You're darn right. That was vicious. He was late on the payments on his hat, and he deserved it. In fact, I've been watching him for a long time, and he never paid any attention to me. But now he is, and he's going to get me in the ring.
Well, you stole his hat.
And well, you steal no hat. Say, I'm a nice guy. Ain't no thief.
I'll tell you what. The Macho Man, Randy Savage, is very upset. You should hear the comments he is making.
What do you mean making a comment?
Yes, he can hear you right now.
Let me hear that. Let me hear that.
Hey, you're going to get a Monday Night Raw hangover. Let's do the thing right now. Come on up here, and I'm going to... Hey, where do you want to land, Repo Man?
Hey, when I hit you from behind and you flew, that's just the start of it. Because when I get you again, it's going to be worse. It's going to be like right down here in New York, right down here in Manhattan. It could be a street fight.
Yeah, that's you're right. Not a chance on you doing the thing to me again. Hey, you got a good kickoff right there. How about a New York street fight?
Hey, just remember, I have your hat.
Hey, I don't care.
And that's your prized possession.
That's okay. Hey.
You were late with that payment, and I got it.
Hey, brother, that doesn't even make it with me.
Come on, tough guy.
You made a... Oh, is that
right? You want to wrestle?
Hey, no, I don't want to wrestle. I want to do something different. We're going to have a date. Don't be late, brother. Just...
Hey. Now, wait a minute, Savage. This is going to be great because I'm going to put the boots to you.
I can't wait to get you in the ring.
I got your attention. This is going to be great.
All right, let's take you now to the Royal Rumble report.
This is it.
Macho Man Randy Savage is kicking off.
Get a word with
the Manhattan Center.
Ric Flair. If he can. Oh, no. I don't think we're going to get a word at all. No.
Big fight going on, Bartlett.
It's still going on.
Perfect one, Flair, no doubt about it. Hey, Sane, come on, but he's not going toward perfect. He doesn't.
You don't talk to me. The rules now. The WWF isn't big enough for me and Mr. Perfect. So right here, live in front of God and the whole world, here next week, I want perfect!
All right, that's pretty clear. You can't get any clearer than that. Ric Flair with a gift.
One of us stays, one of us goes. Not out of the building, but out of the WWF.
I can't believe you had risked your career, Mr. Flair. I can't believe you would do that. And I'm not too sure that Mr. Perfect is going to do that either. I can't, and you started
I can tell you right now, you're not mad enough. You haven't got the guts, and you will never see the day in your life you beat Ric Flair.
Take a Prozac.
Yes, that's pretty clear. Ric Flair issuing a challenge to Mr. Perfect. Hopefully, before we go off the air, we will have a retort of some sort, perhaps an answer from Mr. Perfect. Guys, I don't know what to say. We're rocking and rolling here.
Sounds like the end of the road for somebody, guaranteed. Here he comes. There's my guy right there, Mr. Perfect.
Well, I guess we didn't have to wait. I don't know if you heard that challenge or not from Ric Flair. He states the WWF is not big enough for the two of you. He's going to put his career in the WWF on the line, if you will.
You're talking about meeting Ric Flair, and the loser has to leave the World Wrestling Federation?
Here, right here next week.
Are you kidding me? I'll take that in a heartbeat. Ric Flair, you're going to be gone. McMahon, you know me. Everybody knows me. I am what I say I am, Flair. You want me? You got me right here.
I must say, I can't imagine you putting your career on the line like that, or even Ric Flair. It's going too far. Both of you are great competitors. Why risk that?
Is that what it has to take? Ric Flair, is that what it's gone down to? The two greatest athletes in the World Wrestling Federation? Only one man will stay in the World Wrestling Federation? I'll take that challenge. I'll put my career on the line right here.
Thank you very much. It can't be any clearer than
Perfect.
That. Mr. Perfect puts his career on the line next week, one-on-one with Ric Flair.
Great pleasure at this time to welcome the reigning World Wrestling Federation champion, Ric the Hitman
Flair. What a champion! What an ovation for the Hitman! Of the sold-out crowd in Sacramento, California, will be cheering on the Hitman as he squares off against Razor Ramon.
This Sunday at the Royal Rumble, everything's at stake for all the marbles.
You know, Raymond, you know what everybody says to me over and over and over? They always say, people's champion.
Yo.
People's champion.
Hey, yo.
Hey, wait a minute. What's that?
Hitman. Shut up.
Wait a minute. Look at this.
Shut up.
What do you want? What is this? What is this?
Bret Hart. The people's choice.
That's
the
right,
working man's champion. 8.5 years in the WWF. WWF.
Where'd this guy come from?
The tag team champion.
That's right.
Two times.
Rock somewhere. Why don't you come out here?
Shut up, Chico. Two times the Intercontinental champion. And now you climb your way to the very, very top. You're the main man.
That's right, brother.
You're the WWF champion. Say hello to the bad guy. Hey, Chico, squashing your baby brother like a cockroach? That was fun, man.
What a lowlife.
And Chico, if I see your daddy walking the street, I may slap his face too.
Ooh.
Because Razor Ramon takes whatever he wants.
Hey, let me tell you something, Razor Ramon.
Karate, Chico. Razor Ramon takes whatever he wants. And Hitman, I want you.
You want me?
I want you.
You want a piece of me so bad, you think you're so tough. Why don't we come out here right now? Come out from behind your rock. Let's do it, brother.
Yeah,
we don't need to wait for the Royal Rumble. We can
you
step out
me?
Right now.
Slap
go in that ring
punk.
And finish
I
this thing.
Face,
let's
punk.
Do it.
Huh?
Come on. You're gutless. Where's
oil
your
man,
guts?
Chico. Oil man. Listen to me. Nobody tells Razor Ramon what to do. Nobody tells Razor Ramon when to do it. You want to fight Razor Ramon? You got it. Este Domingo, Chico, this Sunday. Royal Rumble. And Chico, you look at me, you punk.
Oh.
There is nothing your fans can do. There is nothing tu familia, your family can do. And Hitman, there is nothing you can do to stop Razor Ramon from taking your precious gold.
Let me tell you something, Razor Ramon. The name's not Chico, the name's Hitman. And let me tell you something, I take pride in being the World Wrestling Federation champion. This Sunday in the Royal Rumble, we're all gonna take pride when I kick your butt.
Oh yeah! The Hitman Bret Hart, the WWF champion, defends the title this Sunday at the Royal Rumble.
This report is brought to you by the Royal Rumble program. All of the inside scoop on this year's Royal Rumble. And it's on newsstands right now. Folks, speaking of the Royal Rumble, this Sunday afternoon at 4 p.m. Eastern Time, undoubtedly one of the World Wrestling Federation's most exciting events of the year will be taking place. And of course, you can see it all live on pay-per-view cable TV. Call your local cable company right now. the main event, featuring World Wrestling Federation champion Bret the Hitman Hart meeting challenger Razor Ramon. I'm sure you saw earlier on how these two men feel about each other. I guarantee you, there is no love lost between either man. Now then, out of the Royal Rumble with 30 of the greatest superstars in the World Wrestling Federation today, all competing to win this big event. Coincidentally, the winner of this year's Royal Rumble will have the opportunity of meeting the World Wrestling Federation champion at WrestleMania 9 in Caesar's Palace, Las Vegas, Nevada. In the Royal Rumble, there are no friends. It is every man for himself. And here's just a sampling of the great talent on display this Sunday afternoon at sold-out Arco Arena in Sacramento. You'll see the Nasty Boys, Brian Knobs, and his partner, Jerry Sags. Native American superstar, Tatanka. And this 500-pound-plus monster, Yokozuna.
Royal Rumble. Look at my Yokozuna. 6 feet five. 505 pounds.
Yosh!
There's 29 more opponents in ring. And let me tell you, my Yokozuna has never been off his feet. So coming this Sunday in Royal Rumble, he'll be very victorious. In WrestleMania, he'll take the championship belt and all the money back home to Japan.
Yosh! Yosh! Buzzer!
Oh, the list goes on. The Undertaker, Damian Demento, the Head Shrinkers, Samu, and Fatu. And this man, Mr. Perfect.
This Sunday, the Royal Rumble, 30 of the finest athletes the World Wrestling Federation has to offer. Big men, strong men, fat men, all shapes and sizes. But there's only one man who's perfect, and that's Mr. Perfect. Last year, Ric Flair, you won the Royal Rumble only because Mr. Perfect had advised you on how to win it. Well, this year, I'm in it for Mr. Perfect. And the winner of the Royal Rumble gets a shot at the World Wrestling Federation Championship at WrestleMania. I'll guarantee you one thing. I'll win the Royal Rumble because I am what I say I am. And that's perfect.
By the way, I'm sure Mr. Perfect will be watching very intently when Bobby Heenan unveils Narcissus at the Royal Rumble. I, for one, could hardly wait. Back to more names at this year's Royal Rumble. The Big Man, Typhoon, El Matador, Tito Santana, and this man, former World Wrestling Federation champion, Bob Backlund.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, have you ever had to wait 10 long years for something and be patient? Well, I've got an opportunity to win a chance to wrestle the WWF title holder in WrestleMania. If I can be victorious in the Royal Rumble on Sunday.
Oh, it reads like the who's who. Papa Shango. From Japan, the great Tenryu. Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase. His partner, Irwin R. Scheister. Plus this man, last year's Royal Rumble winner, Nature Boy Ric Flair.
It's this Sunday we're going to make history one more time. Last year, we beat all the WWF superstars in one night to win the World Wrestling Federation Championship. And this Sunday, we're going to do it one more time. Why? Because I'm the Nature Boy. And what comes out of this mouth is as good as gold. Put it in the bank. This Sunday, Ric Flair wins the Royal Rumble and goes on to WrestleMania to take the title for the third time. Woo!
The battle lines have been drawn for this Sunday afternoon in Sacramento. The 30-man Royal Rumble, the main event for the World Wrestling Federation title. A tremendous assortment of other outstanding matches, plus the unveiling of Narcissus by Bobby the Brain Heenan. Folks, it all adds up to one of the most exciting afternoons in World Wrestling Federation history. Now, even though you cannot be in one of those 18,000 seats in Sacramento, you can experience the thrill of the Royal Rumble live on pay-per-view cable TV. Don't wait another minute. Run, don't walk to your telephone and call your local cable company right now. The action starts at 4 p.m. Eastern Time this Sunday afternoon. Make it happen. Join us for the 1993 Royal Rumble.
We're back with more World Wrestling Federation action, and in just a few moments, we're going to be joined by a superstar indeed. I believe under new management, as we know it today.
Not management, an advisor.
Well, very, very good point.
Who are you guys talking about?
The pastor of the Mount Ephraim Baptist Church in Fort Worth, Texas, about ready to lead down to the ring. Take a look, King.
How do you like this, King?
I don't like him at all. I don't like him one thing about him. What do you mean this slicks his advisor? What can he advise him on? Who to eat for dinner?
Better than Harvey Whippleman, a lot better. In fact, 100% better.
As relates to his former relationship with Kamala. I think Harvey actually blames The Undertaker for turning things around, and then from there, certainly blames the Reverend Slick for showing Kamala a little different side of things, sort of seeing the light, if you will.
Harvey Whippleman is a close personal friend of mine.
I don't doubt it.
He told me that Kamala has never been the same since that low-life Undertaker locked the man inside a coffin. Would you be the same if you were locked inside a coffin?
Harvey Whippleman's gonna have to get over it and get on with his own life, which is not too much to look forward to.
Well, I can tell you this, Reverend Slick has solicited this capacity crowd and has asked him to help Kamala. Wait a minute now, Dusty Wolf doesn't want to help matters at all.
I figured that was his only chance to go against Kamala that way.
Big shot, yeah! And I was saying before, Reverend Slick wants this crowd to sort of help Kamala advance in life and help him when he needs help to turn somebody over. Maybe tell him what to do from ringside.
You know, I'm going to need a lot of help now that he's without Kimchi and Harvey Whippleman. They were the leaders of that team. They were the ones that made Kamala the great athlete that he was.
I'll tell you, Kamala looks more loosey-goosey right now. Like
as a matter of fact, we had an occasion to pick up his comments earlier.
So now Kamala's being advised by a reverend. Well, it's good for him, because he'll have to say his prayers when he steps in the ring with my Kimchi.
Well, how about that Kimchi squaring off against the Ugandan giant, the mighty Kamala, in a match to come sometime in the near future. But speaking of matches in the future, it's this Sunday afternoon. You two gentlemen going at it, along with 28 other competitors in the very same match in the Royal Rumble. And I might add, during the Royal Rumble, you're going to have an opportunity to hear from some of the winners all the way through the entire broadcast, just like we did at the Survivor Series.
Well, I guess the King's not going to be talking on the hotline, because you're not going to have anything to do about winning.
Wait. There you see here.
No.
You see Kamala listening to the fans now. Look, they're helping him. Look, they're saying, Tony, yes. They're telling him what to do.
He doesn't know what they're saying. He's
yes,
an idiot.
He did it.
Oh.
There is progression.
Yes.
See that guy laying flat on his back, Macho Man? That's just the way you're going to be doing when I get through with you at the Royal Rumble.
Unbelievable. That's never going to happen.
Yeah, that will happen.
You know it's not going to happen.
You don't know what's going to happen.
Nobody knows what's going to happen at the Royal Rumble. We're going to see some guy by the name of Narcissus. Who's Narcissus?
I don't know who Narcissus is. All I know is I'm going to beat the King at the Royal Rumble and take it. Yeah.
I'm going to get my hands on you right now.
Let's take you to Bobby Heenan and learn a little bit more about Narcissus.
You know, humanoids, when you think about it, there's never a dull moment here in the World Wrestling Federation. There's always something going on, especially during a World Wrestling Federation pay-per-view. Well, this Sunday afternoon's Royal Rumble is going to epitomize the grandeur, the spectacle, the excitement you have come to expect at the World Wrestling Federation pay-per-views. One of the reasons is because shockwaves will be heard around the world when I unveil to you and all the other superstars in the World Wrestling Federation, especially you, Mr. Perfect, the quintessential male specimen, Narcissus. Now, Perfect, I know you and everybody else have been wondering, who is Narcissus? Is he really the metamorphic Adonis that Bobby Heenan says he is? Does he really possess the Herculean strength and power? Does he really have the agility, the finesse, the speed, and technical skills of all the greatest wrestlers in the world combined? Well, the answer is that as eloquent and intelligent as I am, even I cannot describe in mere words the affirmations of the above this Sunday afternoon at the Royal Rumble. Behold, the narcissist!
Hello, everybody, and welcome to WWF Monday Night Raw. I'm Sean Mooney, and it is certainly Raw here in New York City. We are anxiously awaiting the arrival of Repo Man. And after what took place last week, Repo Man, you're a little bit late here.
What do you mean I'm a little bit late? Nobody knows where I am at any time, and I'm here. I think I'd miss this moment.
I don't know. A lot of people didn't know if you were going to show up tonight to face the Macho Man, Randy Savage, after what took place last week.
This is like repossessing a brand new Cadillac. Randy Savage! I'm going to repossess your career just like I did your head. I'm here. You better be ready for me, because I'm ready for you.
We're back.
Yeah, shut your mouth, kid.
You talking to me, man?
What?
You talking to you?
I hope not. Randy Savage with a shot to the midsection there. Uppercut by the Macho Man, Randy Savage. Repo Man's been putting the bad mouth on the Macho Man all the way through this matchup.
So far, he's spoken more than Bill Clinton did last week during the inaugural address.
He's made more sense.
Macho Man Randy Savage snapped out now by Repo Man. What a matchup, a grueling matchup this has been thus far. Oh, my.
I'd say it's been 50-50, yep. With maybe the Repo Man having the advantage.
I don't know.
Here's a cover! Count of two and a kick out.
Savage is pretty serious. Matter of fact, earlier I saw him writing a letter to Jody Foster.
That's serious. And Randy Savage turning
is
into
he
Repo
talk
Man.
About?
What?
What's he talking about?
Ask him.
Pick up a paper every once in a while, will you, Heenan?
It does, but it has leaves on it. You know, the kind of, well, never mind.
Smart, real smart.
By the way, a little bit later on, Mean Gene Okerlund will bring us up to date on all the happenings that took place just yesterday afternoon at the Royal Rumble out in Sacramento, California.
You mean my co-host on All American?
I beg your pardon?
That's my co-host on All American, Mean Gene Okerlund.
Yes, he has that rather dubious distinction. Randy Savage back up now with leverage. A little kick there to the chest area.
You'd say Coachella.
Ooh, what a clothesline by Repo Man. Wow.
Who is that masked man?
I don't know, Kemosabe.
And Repo Man continues to pour it on the Macho Man, Randy Savage. He is that. He's macho. Randy Savage is.
What makes you think so? What really makes you think
that? What a great competitor. Come on. Former World Wrestling Federation champion on two different occasions. Give me a break.
So is Ric Flair.
Well, Ric Flair is about, I believe, ready to say bye-bye to the World Wrestling Federation a little bit later on. Either that or Mr. Perfect says adios. Oh,
dump him.
Suplex,
yes.
Down to the canvas. Repo Man. Maybe running out of gas here. I don't know. Here's a cover. One. Hooks the leg again.
He's still on
the count of two.
It's all right. He's in pretty good shape yet.
Yeah.
That needle's not on E.
Really wish Repo Man was at the inauguration last week.
Why is that?
Well, we could have stood to have him steal Hillary Clinton and Tipper Gore's hats.
Hey, I like those hats. And how about that evening gown she had on, huh, Hillary?
Yeah.
What a looker.
Really? Rush Limbaugh liked it, I understand.
Well, you didn't like it?
I thought she looked lovely, actually.
My friends, mega diddles to you, live from the WWF Monday Night Raw.
I know that voice.
Yeah?
That's Paul Harvey, isn't it?
No, it's Ronald McDonald.
Oh!
Down goes Repo, and the action came back. Oh, my goodness! Macho Man Randy Savage turning a title. Look at this match.
You see that Repo? He's just got it in him. He's a competitor. He's got that street smarts. He goes out at night. That's when he likes to work. That's when he does his best work.
Yeah.
And he's taking it right to the Macho Man.
Yeah, Macho what?
He's yelling at you, McMahon. He doesn't like you.
You better concentrate on the Macho Man, Randy Savage. The hat, somewhat symbolic about what this match is all about.
Whoa.
Yes! Way up high for the clothesline. Randy Savage scooping up Repo. Slams him down to the canvas. Randy Savage now going to the outside. Savage going up. The official trying to get in the way, but Randy Savage is on the top rope. And what's going to happen with Randy? Yes!
Yo. I thought he'd move. I thought the Repo would get out of the way.
Not going to do it. That's it. Yes!
Savage from the blue line.
What a lucky victory. What? I said, what a lucky victory. Are you deaf?
Macho Man Randy Savage victorious on Monday Night Raw and Repo Man hurled to the outside.
First thing I'd like to say, Hitman, is congratulations.
Yeah, first thing I'd like to say is you got lucky again, Hitman.
Well, Hitman Bret Hart, it appears at WrestleMania, it's you versus Yokozuna one-on-one. What about it?
Well, you know, Vince, Yokozuna is going to get his shot at WrestleMania, and everybody knows that now. But for me, I got a lot of things on my mind besides Yokozuna. I got all the toughest challengers lined up. They're all stacked up, and they all want a shot at me, and they all want a shot at the World Wrestling Federation title. But for me, I can only take this thing one day at a time. One step at a time, and that means going through all these guys. And Yokozuna, I promised I'd be a fighting champion, and I'm gonna be a fighting champion. And when it comes a little closer, when it gets just that much closer to WrestleMania, that's when I'm gonna start worrying about you.
Ladies and gentlemen, my guest this week is a man who is proud of his name. He is also proud of his heritage, and indeed proud of his country. He is a true American. Let's welcome Hacksaw Jim Duggan!
Oh yeah, here comes the big guy with all the glory flying high!
Does he look proud or does he look proud?
Hacksaw Jim Duggan, son of a chief of police up in Vince Falls, New York.
You know, Raymond, I for one can understand a man being proud of his country, for I carry the flag of the United States of America wherever I go throughout this world. But when Mr. Fuji and Yoko Tommy or Tommy or whatever he calls himself comes to our country and talks about the lazy American workers, that we have lost our work ethic, that we can no longer make good automobiles, good cars, or good stereos, then someone has to do something about it. And Hacksaw Jim Duggan is that man.
Hey! What's he gonna do? Admit that the guy's telling the truth? That's about all you can do about
it. Just tell
you
like it is. Yet, no one here in the World Wrestling Federation has been able to knock Yokozuna off his feet.
Yes, I'm aware of that. I'm aware that big Yokozuna has not been knocked off his feet. But right now, I'm going to challenge him. Hacksaw Jim Duggan, best American, challenges that large Japanese man to bring his Japanese flag to the ring, to bring his Japanese manager to the ring. And I not will only knock him off his feet, but I will stand over him with the stars and stripes and wave it proudly. For I will not quit. I will not stop. I will not waver. For as long as there's air in my lungs and blood in my heart, I will attack, attack, attack. So help me God.
Wow! I like it.
Mr. Fuji's court.
Well, you know, they're very proud gentlemen. You throw a challenge to them, they're going to accept it. You can bet on that.
Well, perhaps before this program is over, we'll have some kind of response to Hacksaw's challenge. Oh, listen to the ovation here for Marty Jannetty. What a match he had at the Royal Rumble.
One of the greatest matches I ever witnessed. But you notice there's no sensational Sherry. I hear rumor that she's back with Shawn Michaels, begging him to take her back.
Jesus!
I heard they were seen together just about a half hour ago. That's my source.
Why don't you be serious?
Believe me, Monster, I'm not the
kind of... Take a look, Brain! Who's that?
That's an imposter. That can't be her.
That's an imposter, huh?
Well, nobody walks like that. I guess that is her.
What a tremendous ovation for Sensational Sherry!
Boy, you know, I used to think she had some taste.
some class. But to hang around with Marty Jannetty, you're wasting your time, bimbo.
Shawn Michaels in that matchup held on to his title just by the skin of his teeth.
Barely. But he still is the Intercontinental Champion.
Yes, he is.
I can't believe her. She's a scorned woman. You see, she begged
Shawn. Scorned woman?
She begged Shawn to take her back, and he dumped her.
Please.
So she got the second best she could find.
What a fountain of misinformation you are.
That's what Shawn told me.
Was that before or after he left the building?
During.
Oh. Marty Jannetty certainly gave him a run for the money, and I think Shawn was a little bit put out, Brain, at Royal Rumble.
Why? Because Sherry chose to be in the corner of Marty Jannetty?
Absolutely. She finally saw the light.
Face it, Jannetty's doing what he usually does. He picks up Shawn Michaels' scraps.
Oh, please. Well, earlier on, we had a chance to talk with Sensational Sherry, and her thoughts are profound.
There's only one man that came to my aid at the Royal Rumble, and that's Marty Jannetty. And wherever you're going to be, Shawn Michaels, I'll be right there with Marty Sr.
Eat your heart out, Shawn Michaels.
She'll be right there at Marty's side, like to make him jealous. Shawn Michaels doesn't care. He dumped her.
Are you kidding?
Well, he told me.
Do you know how many matches Sensational Sherry was instrumental in winning for Shawn Michaels?
None.
A lot of them.
No.
Yes.
You've been listening to Jannetty. You've been listening to Sherry.
All I have to do is watch, Brain.
You really enjoy her change of attitude, don't you?
Well, I think everybody deserves a second chance, Brain.
It's simple. Marty Jannetty couldn't buy a date, and Sherry couldn't find one. They deserve each other.
Are you kidding? You'd like to have this guy's leftovers.
Leftovers? Me?
Yeah, you.
Are you kidding? I make my own way through life. I don't have to pick up anybody's scraps.
Maybe you could double date with that other scrounge of yours, Lex. What's his
scrounge?
Name? Yeah, you got it.
Narcissus?
He resembles that remark, yeah.
The most finely tuned human being walking the face of this earth.
He's got a great body. I'll give you that, Brain.
Great looks, great mind.
But he's a little short between the ears.
You're jealous. It's coming out.
Not me. Why would I be jealous?
Well, then why don't you... Never mind.
Youngster now ramming Jannetty headfirst into that top turnbuckle. Oh, look at that.
Don't know, buddy. See, you can't let a woman influence your thinking.
Uh-oh, here it comes.
Ooh.
Lights out.
He's not going anyplace.
That one up. Very impressive indeed.
She just hanging around to
no,
get back at
item.
Shawn Michaels.
They're not an item.
Well, then get out of the ring, bimbo.
Marty Jannetty is an item all by himself. Well, for weeks we've been talking about Ankle Pro, and right now we're going to take you to the good doctor.
The following contest is scheduled.
Another tremendous shot of this capacity crowd here.
Weighing 245
and coming up in just a few moments, Brain, one of the reasons why.
East.
A debut.
And his opponent. Doink.
Something wrong with this guy.
Boy, oh boy. Showed up at the World Wrestling Federation, I thought he was funny. A lot of things he does makes me laugh. But I'll tell you, there's something about this guy that just puts goosebumps on my goosebumps.
He's sick, right? Like you.
He is dangerous. I mean, he changes personalities just like that. One minute he's laughing, next minute he's crying. Next minute he's laughing, next minute he's making you cry.
He reminds me of someone right out of the snake pit.
Talk about deranged.
Well, remember what he did a couple of weeks ago on WWF Superstars with that prosthesis arm that he had, just whacked, crushed, and put him out of dimension.
You had a meeting with
with Slaughter. Sergeant Slaughter, the trouble shooter.
He picked that thing up, you know, and it was lined with lead.
Lead?
Weighed about 35 pounds.
Well, that's not funny.
No, not at all. Well, nice fireman's carry.
You know, that's what makes him so dangerous. This man is not just a clown with funny looking hair and a red nose. He is an accomplished wrestler. He knows what he's doing in that ring.
Look at that, there's a nice half crab there as well.
But look how the legs are spread out, how he's got his weight distributed. He knows what he's doing. This is an accomplished wrestler.
Well, he better know what he's doing, Brain, because he has made an enemy for life in Crush. Golden opportunity was sidetracked by that man right there as he put Crush literally right out of the Royal Rumble and any chance to get a shot at the title.
Sometimes that's a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. Look at this. He is skillful.
Let's hear what this sick person has to say.
What do they say? The bigger they are, the harder they... No! The bigger they are, the dumber they are. Crush fell for the oldest one in the book, the old arm of the sling. And he found out, just like every other wrestler's gonna find out, I'm armed and I'm dangerous. Yeah!
He's psychotic, Brain.
Drop kick right on the money. I'm telling you, I'm impressed. You know, he looks familiar to me.
He does.
He really does.
Nice short snap. Suplex.
That's what I just said.
Oh.
Look at this. Look at the holds this man knows. He's not your average clown.
Well, he used a crucifix with a half grab to get the victory. This guy, undoubtedly, Brain, has some tremendous sadistic tendencies.
Wow. Your best bet's to make friends with him quick.
Not me.
I can't put my finger on it, but I know him.
No. Well, it takes one sick person to know another one. Let's go back and take a look.
Now, look at this wrestling move. That's not your average clown move. Look at this. Right on the money. Watch the personality change here. Look at this. Look at the eyes. Oh, get the straitjacket out.
Event center coming up. Here we go. Take it away.
Hacksaw Jim Duggan, Yokozuna, and myself accept your challenge. We'll meet right here next week.
Yes! Yes!
But let me give you a warning, Hacksaw. No one has ever took my Yokozuna off his feet. You need all the luck.
Oh,